Today on Testify, we share with you the story of Angelica Wanjiku Mwangi, commonly known as Angel Mwangi. She is the founder of As They Blossom, which is a ladies' club. Despite being a victim of a broken relationship that left her with a son, she has touched the life of many girls, especially in the coastal region. Welcome.
My name is Angelica Wanjiku Mwangi, better known as Angel. That is what most of my friends call me. Yeah, and I was born and raised in Thika, but currently I live in Mombasa. I'm a missionary at Ukunda Mission School. I was born in Thika by a very wonderful woman called Mary and my dad, Zakaria Mwangi. And I went to primary school in Thika still, at St. David's Primary School. Later on, I went to Thika Muslim Primary School. After that, I went to high school. Then I went to college. Yeah, and I thank God. This is the far I've come. After that, I went to Mombasa. Yeah, that is where I did my mission training. I thank God because my mom took me to church. She showed me church. So I was introduced to Sunday school when I was young. So it was not a Pentecostal church. It was a Catholic church, but we still went to church every Sunday with my mom and my other family members and my dad. We'd go to church. Yes, so I grew up in church, and I grew up knowing God when I was a little girl. Actually, I really loved reading the Bible. Now, by myself, this was not even my mom, but I just found myself just having a love for reading the Bible. When I was in high school, I attempted to get saved. I'm saying attempted because it was not by conviction. I was getting saved because, I saw people going to the altar to get saved, but I really didn't understand what salvation was. And so it never lasted. It never lasted. It never went anywhere. And actually, when guys used to ask me, "So you're saved?" I used to tell them, "Yeah, I'm saved Catholically." Yeah. Yeah, that's the interesting bit. But when I really got the conviction to get born again, I think it was around, it should be around 11 years back. Yeah, that is when I went to church. Actually, it was on a ladies' meeting. So I went to church and the meeting was awesome. There were these ladies who had come from the States. And they were preaching to us ladies, and they had this hat. They had this drawing of a hat. And it was torn into pieces. It was torn into pieces, into two pieces. And I remember that lady taking that heart, the pieces of the heart, and brought them together and said, "If you will allow Jesus Christ to come into your life, he's going to take the broken pieces in your life and bring and make you whole." I'm telling you, that message, it brought so much conviction in my heart. I felt a love that I've not felt before. And at that moment, unfortunately, there was no altar call that day. So what did I do? I have the conviction and there is no altar call. I took myself to the altar. Everybody was leaving for home. So because the meeting was over. So I went and to the altar. By then I was with my son. I think I should have mentioned I have a son. He's 13 now. He's 13 now. He's praise Mwangi. So by then he was 2 years. So I took my little boy, we walked down the altar, and I tapped my bishop and told me, "Excuse me, sir, I want to give my life to Christ." And he was so happy, and that is how I gave my life to Christ. So after high school, that is when my sister introduced me to Destiny Ministries after high school. She invited me to go at one time. So I went to this church, and when I entered, I saw the worship. You know, this is not something you see from the other church. I saw the worship, the praise, and my heart was just stuck there. So I loved it. And the preaching, I just loved it. I just fell in love with everything about that church. And so when I went back home, somehow I didn't go back to church the following Sunday, and I didn't go back to church. But sometime later is when I remembered that church. And as the Lord was drawing me closer to him, I prayed. Actually, even there was a pastor who came to invite me to his church. But and I prayed to God, God lead me to a church. And that is when he led me to back again to Destiny Ministries.
After completing high school, Angel trained as a computer scientist, even though it wasn't her passion.
By the way, I didn't do the diploma in computer science because I wanted to. Again, I did it because it was the in thing then. I was not passionate about computers. I didn't want any, it was not in me. I just did it because it was the in thing, you know, in my, when I cleared high school, you're either doing computer science or doing IT. Yeah, so somehow I just found myself falling under computer science. But because I didn't really like, I was not passionate about it, I went back again to college and did now what I was passionate about. I did counseling, I did psychology. Yeah, and that is something that I loved. I was passionate about it. I love working with people. I love helping people. And I'm glad I made the right choice.
Before giving her life to Christ, Angel was involved in a relationship with a guy who left her heartbroken. Even though it was a tough season, she had a lot to learn from it.
Let me say my heart was so broken. I was shattered. I felt like the world was, you know, things were not going okay. Things were not, I had this hunger, this thirst in me. I felt that like I just needed something different in my life. I had come from a place where I was in a relationship that left me broken, that left me hurt, and that left me with a child. And I had to move on. You know, I had to look to find purpose for my life. And I was trying now to do all this, to find myself, to realize myself. And this is when, at the same time, the Lord was also inviting me, or the Lord was calling me. And so when I went to church and I just found that lady demonstrating with a heart that had been broken, that had been shattered, and that Jesus was going to pick up that heart. And when you accept Jesus Christ into your heart, he's going to make your heart, he's going to heal you, and he's going to make your heart whole. So I didn't know how much I needed healing in my heart until I had that sermon. I didn't know how much I needed Jesus until I had that sermon. And receiving Jesus then was the best decision that I ever made. The biggest mistake that I made in my relationship with the father of my son is that, honestly, I did not love him. I was just trying to give back. He was a good guy. He was a good guy to me, you know. So I didn't really love him. He's not somebody that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with as my husband. I was just reciprocating the kindness that he was showing me. So I agreed to go out with him, just to be his friend, just to be close to him, just like to reciprocate the kindness. But I found myself trapped and pregnant. I think in life, everything happens for a reason. And I know that God allowed these things to happen in my life for a purpose. Because he knew that he was sending me to young girls. He was sending me to the right people, to the young people. And the experience that the previous experiences that I had, I would use them to help these young people, not to make the same mistakes that I made, not to make uninformed decisions. Because I found myself, I was in a relationship, I didn't know, you know, I made very uninformed decisions, let me say. And that is why I found myself in such kind of a mess. I rushed, you know, I made decisions that were not timely. Yeah, so all these messes, God now has turned them into a beautiful message. You should define the kind of relationship you want with somebody. And make it clear in black and white. For me, I was young and inexperienced. I was very naive. Yeah, so I just found myself making a lot of mistakes and making the wrong decisions. But I don't regret any of them, because today I am able to guide young people, not based on theory, but based with my own life.
Angel now serves as a missionary, spreading the word of God and reaching out to the unreached. But how did she know that God had called her into the mission field?
God had a plan for me in terms of his teaching his word, because I always found myself preaching to my sisters. Yeah, I I'm the fourth born in a family of six. So I would find myself preaching to my elder sisters. So I knew somehow in me there was something, but I had not discovered it. I hadn't known what it was all about. So my real calling came when the Lord started to teach me and he taught me in terms of questions and would ask me to define myself. He would ask me, who are you? Define yourself. And I remember one time, it was late in the night. It was around, it was, my calling was very dramatic. It was around 1 a.m. And the Lord just came into my room. It's like his presence just came into my room. And I was so scared. And I woke up. I was so scared. I felt like a fire. It was like a fire that was burning from within and from without. And for a minute, I thought it was demons or the devil or something. I didn't know what was happening. So I started to rebuke it. And my heart was pacing. It was really pacing. And at that point, I started calling friends, waking people to pray for me. I thought I was sick. I was having some high blood pressure or something. I didn't know what was really happening with me. And anytime I would be quiet and still, it's like the fire would consume me. But anytime I'd wake out of my bed and start running, my heart would really pace and beat so fast. So I was so scared to the point that I was living with my son then, and I went to his room. And in his bed, I crawled like a baby in my son's bed because I was so scared. And the Lord told me, stay away from your son, move away from your son. Oh my God, I went to the living room now and I sat there and I heard a voice tell me, just put on some worship music. I put on some worship music. I started listening to the worship music, and that is where I heard the Lord speak to me and said, you will enter my rest. And in the morning, because I'd even called my mom and everybody, telling them to pray for me, and my mom was so scared. She was calling me through the night. I doubt if she slept that day. Asking if, are you okay? Should we come for you? Should we take you to hospital? But in my heart, I'm convicted. I'm fine. But I just don't understand what is happening. And now when I sat in the living room and I started to listen to the worship songs, the fire, like that fire just consumed me. It just consumed me. And I felt like I was being delivered. I was being set free. And in the morning, I went to work as usual. And when I went to work, I just wanted to continue with the worship songs. But the Lord spoke to my heart. The Spirit of God spoke to my heart and told me, I was listening to a certain radio station, but the Lord told me, take your radio to Hope FM. So at that point, I just wanted to listen, to flow in worship because of the experience I had the previous night. But the Lord is telling me, take your radio to Hope FM. I obeyed, I think, the last 15 minutes. I took finally to Hope FM, and that is where I found Von Martin speaking. Von Martin was speaking in Hope FM about the call of God, that God is calling missionaries from Kenya into Africa and to the ends of the world, people that are going to burn with the fire of God. The fire of mission is going to burn in their hearts, and they're going to take they're going to become missionaries, and they're going to be take the word of God to the ends of the world. And
he told me that in the future, Kenya would send many missionaries, that there would be a missionary movement out of Kenya, and Kenya would be a resource base that would send missionaries into many parts of the world. And it really is time where Kenyans will pay the same price that the early missionaries did. And that calling to missions, that calling to give everything, and not to be in ministry for your own benefit, but to be in ministry as an offering unto the Lord, as an offering to the nations, that calling is very, very strong in Kenya. And I know even now, some of the people listening, they know that call. Yeah. And God gives one chance, he gives two chances, he gives three chances. But the real opportunities to walk out your call, eventually it comes to an end and you miss the chance. All and right. So if you're listening and that calling is there, if it's really there and you know it's there, don't wait.
And now when Von Martin was speaking, I connected the fire he was talking about and the fire that consumed me, that was consuming me and making me run through the night. It connected so much. And I understood that now God was calling me into missions. God was calling me to be a missionary. And God was breaking the fears. Whatever had bound me that night, it's like the fire of God was just literally breaking the fears and everything that could have denied me that opportunity to go out and reach out to people.
And at this point, we take a short break. We will be right back.